Happy morning, students. In the previous lecture, we have designed and derived Wien bridge oscillator. In this lecture, we are going to design LC oscillator. The basic difference between LC and RC oscillator is, in feedback network, RC oscillator was made up of resistors and capacitors. In LC oscillator, the feedback network was designed using inductors and capacitor. And also, LC oscillator is more stable while comparing RC oscillator. That is why we are preferring LC oscillator in more applications. There are two types of LC oscillators was given in your syllabus: Hartley oscillators and Colpitts oscillators. In this lecture, we will derive Hartley oscillator and we will find the frequency response using the analysis.
Okay, let us see the transistorized RC Hartley oscillator. This is the main circuit diagram of Hartley oscillator. The Hartley oscillator consists of two part, amplifier part and feedback part. Here the amplifier part was designed by common emitter configuration. The transistor was connected in common emitter configuration. The output of common emitter amplifier is given as an input of this feedback network. Here the feedback network is designed by inductors and capacitors. That's why it comes under LC oscillator, Hartley oscillator. Two inductor and one capacitor. The output of this feedback network is again fed back as an input of amplifier. Here, this amplifier part, common emitter, will produce 180 degree phase shift, and the feedback part will produce 180 degree phase shift. The total phase shift in the circuit is 360 degree. It will satisfy the Barkhausen condition. In the introduction part itself, I explained the Barkhausen condition. The first condition is the total circuit must produce 360 degree phase shift or 0 degree phase shift. Here, this amplifier part will produce 180 degree phase shift, and the tank circuit, the feedback circuit, will produce 180 degree phase shift. The total phase shift here is 360 degree. This circuit can be called as tank circuit because it seems like a tank, two inductor and one capacitor. Coming to the derivation part, derivation of frequency of oscillation, we have to redraw the equivalent circuit of feedback network. This is the equivalent circuit of feedback network. It is consisting of L1, L2 and C. The L2 was connected with capacitor and the collector terminal of a transistor. Here L2 was connected with the capacitor and also the collector terminal of the capacitor. In hybrid model, the collector terminal was determined by HFE into IB, and L1 was also connected. One end was grounded and another end was connected with collector and also with the input of transistor. L1 was connected with capacitor and also the input of a transistor, input of an amplifier. In hybrid model, input was determined by HIE. That means in hybrid model, the input of transistor, base terminal was HIE, output terminal, collector terminal was HFE into IB. This is the equivalent circuit of feedback network. In the next step, this current source was converted into voltage source by redrawing the inductor, parallel inductor, into series. L2, just we are converting this current source into voltage source. The first equation is written as V0. V0 is equal to the voltage source in the circuit is current HFEIB into the reactance of an inductor. HFEIB into XL2, reactance of an inductor. In Fourier transform, we can write HFEIB into j omega L2. X was replaced as j omega L2. This is equation number 1. Then equation number 2. Equation number 2 is the current in the circuit. Current in the circuit is equal to V divided by total reactance. V was mentioned in negative form because the voltage source, the positive terminal was grounded and negative terminal was given in the upper portion. That's why we are putting this negative symbol divided by the total reactance. L inductor and capacitor was connected in series. That's why we are adding the terms XL2 plus XC, XL2 plus XC, plus these two components are in parallel form, XL1 parallel HIE, XL1 parallel HIE. The next step is just we are rewriting these forms. XL2 plus XC is equal to X, for X we are putting J omega, for XC, for capacitor, we have to write 1 by J omega C, J omega L2 plus 1 by J omega C. Then for this second part, XL1 is parallel with HIE. For that we are using one formula, R, if two resistors are connected in parallel, we will be using one formula, R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. The same formula here we are using, XL1 parallel HIE is equal to, for X we will be putting J omega L1 into HIE divided by J omega L1 plus HIE, the formula. Then we are substituting these two in the main equation. For V0 also we are substituting this equation. V0 is equal to HFE IB J omega L2, the minus is from the main equation, minus HFE IB J omega L2 divided by this term is replaced by this term is replaced by this term. The next step, just we are replacing J omega in by S. J omega was replaced by S. The next step, here we are taking LCM, SL2 plus 1 by SC was rewritten by taking LCM, SL2 into SC plus 1 divided by SC. SL2 into SC, we can write S square, L2 into C, the whole divided by SC. This equation we can write as in the above. In the next step, just we are taking LCM for this both equation both part in the denominator side, 1 plus S square L2C into SL1 plus HIE, the first part, then plus SL1 HIE into SC, the whole divided by SC into SL1 plus HIE will go to the numerator side, SC into SL1 plus HIE. In the next step, just we are multiplying the bracket terms. By multiplying the terms, in the numerator part, S into S, it will become S square. HFEIB L2, this term we are keeping as it is. In later part, it will get cancelled. That's why we are keeping the term as it is. In the denominator part, also we are multiplying the bracket terms. See, this term is getting multiplied with this term, it will become S cube L1 L2 into C plus SL1 into 1, it will become SL1 plus HIE into 1, it will become HIE into S square L2C, it will become S square L2C HIE plus this term, it is multiplied, S into S, it will become S square L1C HIE. In the next part, just we are separating S cube term, S square term, S term and constant term. This is S cube term, S square term, there are two S square term, we can write, we can take common S square L2C as common C HIE. In bracket we can put L2 plus L1 plus S term plus constant term. Keep this equation as it is. Then we'll go for finding IB, that is input of input of an amplifier, which means the output of feedback network. IB is the current flowing through this loop. Using current divider rule, we can find IB. See this equation. IB is the current divider rule. Current divider rule is used to find the current flowing up through a particular component. Here the IB is flowing through IB is flowing through this XL1, that is inductor. The total current flowing through this loop is I. Using current divider rule, we can find the current flowing through a particular component. that is IB, the total using the current divided variable, the total current is I into the particular component XL1 divided by the total component present in the loop. Here the total component present in the loop is XL1 plus HI. See the equation. IB is equal to the total current I into the particular component which the current is flowing, that is XL1 divided by XL1 plus HI, the total component. This is current divider rule. Now we are replacing this X into j omega, then again we are replacing it j omega into S. J omega was replaced by S. Consider this is equation as 4. Already we found this is the equation I. Just we are substituting this equation in this equation. I we found in the previous part. Just we are substituting this I in this IB equation. I is this term into SL1 divided by SL1 plus HI. This is I term. In the next, we can cancel this numerator and this numerator. We can multiply SL1 with the numerator. This part will get cancelled. This S into S, it will become SQ. HFEIB L2, L1 is there, L1 into C. Okay. Now we are substituting. J omega is equal to resubstituting J omega is equal to S. S square automatically will become minus omega square. S cube it will become minus J omega cube. If S is equal to J omega, automatically S cube will become J cube into omega cube. J cube we can write J into J square. It is J square, we know that it is minus 1. So minus J into omega cube. Minus J into omega cube. We are substituting in this equation. For S cube, we are putting minus J omega cube. For S square, we are putting minus omega square. For S term, we are putting J omega. In numerator also, for minus S cube, we are putting minus J omega cube. That's why with the minus minus get cancelled, it is J omega cube. Next part, just we are rationalizing the above equation to separate imaginary part and real part. Here the imaginary part is in numerator and denominator. To separate, we are going for rationalizing method. For that, the denominator complex term was multiplied with its inverse by in numerator and denominator. The complex term was multiplied with numerator and denominator by its inverse. See, denominator, again it will be in the form of a plus b into a minus b. The formula is a square minus b square. This is a term into the inverse of this term. This is a, it will become a square plus b square. B square j square, it will become minus 1. In the formula, general formula, it is having minus. That minus and minus it will get cancelled, then it become plus omega square l1 square, the bracket term square. The next part is rationalizing the above equation. Here the imaginary numerator part is also having imaginary term, denominator is also having imaginary term. To separate the real term and imaginary part, we are going for rationalizing method. Rationalizing means the complex term, denominator complex term was multiplied with numerator and denominator by its inverse. See, this is the complex term, real term plus imaginary term. It inverse was multiplied with numerator and denominator. In denominator, this term was multiplied with a plus b into a minus b. It is in the form of one formula, a plus b into a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. This is a term, HIE minus omega square CHIE into L1 plus L2, the whole square, a square plus b square. Minus b square, that means j square it will become minus 1, minus 1 into minus, that it will become plus omega square l1 square, the bracket term square. And numerator part, the complex term into the numerator part, just we are multiplying the bracket terms. It is equal to 1. 1 means the imaginary, we can put imaginary part is equal to 0. to satisfy the equation, imaginary part RHS must be 0 because the equation is equal to 1. Equal to 1 is equal to 1 plus or minus J0. The imaginary part is 0. So we can equate imaginary part is equal to 0. By equating imaginary part equal to 0, see this term, if you bring this term to right hand side, automatically it becomes 0. This term is equal to 0. Then we can put this one minus term minus this term equal to minus 1. That is omega square c into L1 plus L2 equal to 1. From that we can find omega square. Omega we can say omega is equal to 2 pi f. So instead of omega we can put 2 pi f. F is equal to again 1 by 2 pi root of c into L1 plus L2. This is the final answer. Here from this we can say the frequency or output frequency of this oscillator, output frequency of this oscillator is fully controlled by these two components alone. One is a constant, root of C, capacitor, inductor 1 and inductor 2. The frequency of output frequency of this circuit was fully controlled by inductor and capacitor alone. This is the proof. Thank you. If you have any doubt in this derivation, you can call me. Thank you. Thank you, students.